Okay, today, this is for men and women. We're going to cover a different subject than I usually cover with you. Now, some of you may not have the skill sets, but you can still learn and go get the skill sets. I'm me and he's he or she. When you get out in the street, it's not like being at the range. Everybody's lined up, 20 people. They say, ready, fire, pull, you push it out. In the streets, it doesn't work that way. The streets, what starts out to be a gunfight, ends up being a street fight in most cases. And a street fight involves guns, knives, and everything else. So, that's what we're going to address here. Now, sometimes, if somebody walks up on you and approaches you, you got to back them off. If you have enough distance, then it gives you a lot more options. Up close, you have to react quicker. Because strange things are happening on the street, and violent things are happening on your street. And let me just make one point clear. I don't know how many people are watching have been in Africa. I'm sure a few of you have. The honey badger, 25, 30 pounds, has 3-inch claws. Doesn't give a shit, has a bad attitude. 25, 30 pounds. If a leopard walks up on them, or even a lion, especially if there's two, they run in pairs a lot, they don't back off. Period. That's just it. But once you engage them, whether it's by accident, most of the time it is, because if they see something bigger coming, they're going to get out of the way, they're not stupid. But once you're in a danger range, because they know they can't outrun them, they made up their mind, no matter what happens, they're going to rip a piece of you off. And most of the time, the leopards and lions don't like that because they don't, glasses are fogging up here. They know if they lose their eyesight or get hurt too bad, they'll starve to death. So they leave the honey badgers alone. That's the way I was in the street before I was a cop, when I was a cop, and since I've been a cop. Now, being at my age, if this was a younger bad guy of some sort who I don't know walks up on me in an aggressive manner, the one thing I do know is I'm not going to be out, I'm not going to be able to outrun him unless he's handicapped, because I'm pretty old, which means that puts me in a honey badger mode right off the bat. When I was younger, the option of running, because I was pretty quick when I was a lot lighter, 185 pounds, but that option is gone. So any approach, attack, or threat, I have to deal with it from wherever I am, period. And just like the honey badger, I don't give a shit, and I'm going to rip pieces off you, and you're not getting out of this easy. Even if I'm outnumbered, and there are four guys coming at me, I can't outrun them. If I try, they're going to knock me down, stomp me to death, paralyzed, blind, just like they do to some of those people protesting. I'm not playing that. I don't care what the odds are. If you caught me out in the front, and you're engaging me, once I think you're engaged, I'm the honey badger, it takes me milliseconds, not 2 hours, not a minute, milliseconds. If I'm outnumbered and they're a threat, I know two of them are going right off the bat, pa-pa, because I can't run. So that's the whole thing. Now, if you're in a position you can run and you have cover to run behind, I suggest that. But for you people who are older like me, or can't run as fast, or whatever, sometimes you got to be the honey badger and stand your ground. So if you're close, the guy approaches, and you say, you try to go away, and he keeps getting in the way, then you got an issue this close, because it's hard to engage this close if you can't draw fast. So sometimes you have to defend yourself before you get distance. So if you're this close and he charges you, you kick him in the knee if you're a martial artist. You know, like the knee was down here, so you can kick him in the knee, slow him down, pull the gun out. Like that. Okay? All you need is a half a second, slow him down. Okay? But you have to slow him down, because if you try and he's at a close enough distance and you go for your gun, from here to here he can jump on you. So you've got to do something street fight wise, even if it's to push him off, sweep him. He's down on the ground even if he's got a gun. Too bad. Okay, this is a street fight for your life. So you got, if you don't know martial arts, at least if you know football, you know to block somebody. Somebody's charging you, you block them, push off, and he's your back. Just like that. Okay? You need space to engage. You don't want to let him get any closer than here. If he's getting closer than that, then you go into your fighting type stance. He moves, you move, and he won't stop. Then you're going to have to draw down on him and tell him, leave me alone. If he hasn't pulled a gun yet. But you need to maintain that safe space because he can break that in New York second. Now, if you see him coming, that gives you more of an advantage. Guy looks suspicious down the street. I don't care what color he is. I don't care if he's Jewish. I don't care if he's Amish. White, black, or green. If he looks suspicious, he's suspicious. Now, like the honey badger, they have 3-inch claws. Well, I got 3-inch claws myself. Okay? And if you're a woman, you should have some claws. I would pull that out in my pocket, switch hands with it, and just be hanging out. That way, if he gets too close, I can tell him to back off. Now I got this knife. Now he's not going to be so inclined to jump on top of you. Because you got your honey badger claws out. So now, you told him, back off. I don't want any trouble. Get the hell out of my face. Now, if he charges you, that's the way it goes. That's the way it goes. Okay? Knife is as deadly as a gun. Okay? Hold your hands like this. I'm going to get from here. I'll be out of range from him, okay? Say, I'm out of range. For me to stab him, I got to take a whole step and stab him. So say you're a bad guy. I got to take a whole step. See, I'm out of range. So I can take a whole step to stab him, like that. So if I show you my blade, now when you see me move, see if you can clap your hands like if he was going to try to block me. Before I stab him. Okay, ready? I doubt you did it, okay? That's what it takes. Right in the heart. You can do it front way, you can do it with the left hand, and you can even do it this way. Like here. Same thing. Like if you're ready. Okay? And you can use the slice and dice. If he's kicking, you're going back blocking, cutting the leg. Come back blocking, cut the leg, step back. Okay, this is street fighting. You got your claws, you got your big bite right here. Get some claws, back it up. Because this gives you real good defenses. You can use either hand, and it doesn't take as much time to draw, and it gives you cover that you can draw because you've already pre-pulled it out. Now if you've got your gun outward, and someone sees that, then they might say, I shot him because he had a gun out. Or somebody might say he was brandishing in some states. Okay, now if he's threatening you, I don't give a shit how far he is, that you can use the gun to control the guy so he won't attack you. But he hasn't said anything yet, brandishing can get you in trouble. But if you pull a knife out, you know, you have it behind your back, I said you have a knife, so yeah, just cleaning my nails, what's the problem? Just cleaning your nails with your knife is not brandishing. People don't think a knife will go very far. You're not like pointing it at him, you're just standing there minding your own business. Oh, I gotta go, see you later. Most likely he'll say fine. Have a good day. So, if you pre-set up with this, if you're suspicious, you got it behind your back, just walking around looking like a tourist. And then if he gets aggressive, you tell him to back off, or I'll have to pull my gun. So, he doesn't see very many options. You got a knife in his hand, they go right through his heart, and you got your hand on your gun. Most likely, unless he's A1 stupid, problem over. Now, this part's for women and small men. Well, forget all, it doesn't matter. Women and men, everything apply. Okay, when do you shoot fast, when do you shoot in bursts? First of all, if you're going to shoot fast, let me give you a couple principles. You have to keep the gun from recoiling a lot. So if you pull it out, You want to get a good, tight grip as you can get without moving the finger. See, I got a super tape and I can still control my finger. It takes a little practice to do that, make one finger loose and the rest tight. You can just practice squeezing these fingers at home and doing that, okay? And then you want to pull up on it and pull back here. You want to bring the gun to your eye, okay? To your eye, I'm pushing in, just pushing out with that. And it's like tiring, it's uncomfortable. And if it's comfortable, you're not doing it right. Self-defense, fighting, jiu-jitsu, all that stuff is not comfortable, okay? You get slammed in the ground, uncomfortable. But that's how you win. So you gotta get a good tight grip, You pull it in and push it in like this. You're looking right over the sight, it comes right to your eye. You don't wanna search for it, you want the gun to come to you. And you're ready to fire, rapid fire. If you hold it good like that, so good, you hold it tight, you can shoot burst like that, the gun hardly moves. But if you're holding it loose, like hold it loose, I don't want to waste the ammo on the target. If you're holding it loose, the difference is, it starts spreading a little bit. Now if you hold it nice and tight, pull it in, see? Two shots right there. So, that's the guy with a good, tight grip. Now, some people just push it straight out and they don't think about their arms. What position your arms in and all that stuff, because you're going to feel pressure up in here. Because you're squeezing and you're pulling. And you're up. You got the sight right on my eyes. Bring it up, boom, see? Bring it up, boom. See? Bring it up. All in the center. But it's uncomfortable. Now bring it up. I don't want to shoot my camera, bring my finger out there. Bring it up, boom. Bring it up, boom. Now it's more comfortable for me to relax, like on target shooting. Then I hold it real light. Like when I shoot 100 yards, which I might do in a couple minutes, that's a totally different style. When I shoot 100 yards, I hold it, I relax. I hold it just enough so the gun doesn't go flying out of my hand. Because I have all day. I hold it, and I'm thinking, trigger pull, trigger pull, trigger pull, trigger pull, trigger pull. But actually, it's a trigger push. And that's the whole thing. See, I do different styles for different type of shooting. When I shoot at 900 yards in a role place of fire game, it ain't the same as shooting rapid fire in an AR. Everybody tries to shoot everything the same. It doesn't work that way. When you're having fun with your wife or your girlfriend in private moments, this is a family moment here, you don't do everything the same. I'm just saying, that's what I'm trying to say. So, how you control the gun, how you grip it, and how you're shooting it, how you'll grip it. Now there's sometimes, you don't have time to get two hands on the gun. I'll address that next. Okay, why would you shoot one-handed? One of the reasons is, you got your knife out, okay? You pull it out because you're suspicious, so your hand's full. And the guy stops, or won't stop, whatever, you say, stop now. This hand's full, so you're gonna pull your gun out because he's not stopping. Now you warn him. Women don't like to yell a lot, but you have to let them know you're not playing. You don't say, would you stop, sir? Would you stop, please? You know, you can say, stop right there! You're a threat to me, back off! You have to be authoritarian. Authoritative, not authoritarian. Authoritative. Let them know you're not playing. So, this depends on your circumstance. It's in the dark. You're already threatening with a knife. And you're verbalizing. All the people with their little camcorders on are filming it. And women, it works a whole lot better for men, but men, you may not have a choice, like I told you before. Okay? So, you've already told him with a knife, you're a threat to him. Now you pulled your gun and you scream for him to stop, and he continues. Okay? And here's the problem. They say, well, he's unarmed. He's not unarmed because I've got two weapons. If he comes, takes over me, he kills me with my weapon. Happens to cops all the time. If I was a uniformed cop, that's why there's no unarmed men in a uniformed cop fight, because the cop has the gun. You lose, you get killed with your own gun. So you tell him, stop! And you start backing off because you're giving in. And he keeps following you, you say, stop! Well, like I say, it gets dangerous because right now you don't want to turn your head away from him because you turn your head, he can shoot. You don't want to go any further, just keep him coming. So at that point, you got to do what you think you have to do. If you want to back off, but he's not coming, hold him there and just keep saying, stop, someone call the police, stop, someone call the police. Okay, all of a sudden he reaches in his pants, he pulls out a gun. As soon as you see it's coming out, you have to do what you have to do. You have to do it with one hand, both in the X-ray. Okay? One hand shooting, you got to learn one hand shooting. Same, shoot him in the head, same thing. Right in the head, okay? One hand. Because this hand's full, or this hand's injured. Okay? So, let's keep this up here. Now it might fall, get dirty. If you're close like that, you got to make sure you give him commands. No, I'm going to be using two hands. He's coming, you're going back, but make sure you take a quick glance. All you need is a quick glance. Boom. Nobody else is behind you. Boom, boom. Stop, stop, stop. He doesn't stop. You have nowhere else to go. You have to make up your mind what you're going to do. Now, this gun is also a weapon if you don't fire it. You can block his hand and hit him in the head, but then again, if he grabs it, then you're fighting over your gun. So you don't really want to give it that much space. So you get to this point, if he doesn't pull weapon, you're backed up against a wall. You know, you're older, you're a woman, and you obviously can't beat this guy, and he's going to take a gun and kill you. You tell him that, verbalizing, you're threatening me, you're going to hurt me, you're going to kill me, back off or I'll have to shoot. If he doesn't back off, do what you have to do. Give plenty of warning. Now, if he's kind enough to pull a knife or pull a gun out, it's the same thing. As soon as you see it's gun, that way, if he shoots, you're not in the same spot. Same thing. Gun! Same thing. Gun! Okay? Move, stay, but keep that distance and verbalize. You're scaring me. You're scaring me. Same thing. Okay? Verbalize. When a video comes on CNN, you want to be the one saying, stop! Scaring me, you know, whatever. Make sure, and if you should be scared. If a stranger is approaching you in the dark, you got a gun, he's not backing off, you got a problem. You should be scared. And if you tell them that many times, that loud, then they can't say, well, you murdered a guy. How do you murder a guy? He's going to come take my gun and murder me. I yelled at him 20 times, he keeps approaching, as you can see. So that's what you do, because you don't want to have to shoot anybody, ever. Okay? Because then you can get judged by 12 jurors, like some of these people, this last cop last week, defended himself. The FBI checked out the shooting. The police part checked out the shooting, was cleared. But the local people still charged with murder, which is asinine. But that's the kind of thing you can expect if you're in the wrong city. If you're in Portland, that can happen, so you gotta really talk. If you're in Dallas, and you do what I just showed you, and he still comes after you, and you're telling him you're scared, you're probably not in as much trouble because they view it differently. Because one's anti-gun and one's pro-self-defense. So where you are doing the same thing, it'd be two different things. But the bottom line is, you can't let anybody kill you. I don't care where you are. You're going to have to, if you got to defend yourself, you got to defend yourself, and you got to go to court. As soon as the shooting's over, cop comes, what happened? I'll tell you everything that happened as soon as my attorney gets here. I want to ask you questions now. You can ask what questions you want. My name's Henry Hill. Yep. That's that. What happened with the shooting? I'll tell you everything about the shooting you want as soon as the attorney gets here. Boom. Zip. End the case. Bingo. Well, the last few shots you didn't get to see in person. So, all the shots were in the head or in the center of the body. X-rings, nine rings, stuff like that. I was talking, not fully focused, but still. If you do like I tell you, get the gun up to your eye and learn to put the bullet where your eye's looking, you'll hit them all day long. at the close ranges. Let's go try some fire ranges.
Go for it.
All right, 10 rounds and 100.
Just a bit off his ear, right to the right of his ear. Right, upper left chest. Upper right chest. You want to do it? Am I hitting it?
I don't see where that last one went. I think that last one was off.
Did it hit it at all yet?
Yeah. You got three shots.
I didn't know you were talking to me. I couldn't hear it through his ears.
I think you got upper left, upper right, lower left.
And right
got,
by the ear.
Two upper left chest, one upper right, and one off the ear.
Run right off the ear.
Oh, one.
That was the first shot.
The ear. Yeah.
Gut shot. Right through the belly. Oh, we got three right at the bottom of the paper.
All right. Let me go see what it looks like up close. How many hits did I get? Did you see?
I see